I'm just rolling.
Maybe let's get the nicotine gum out of the shop.
Hey guys, welcome to Tasker Street.
Should I do this, sir?
It's fine.
Just look cooler.
We're about to install star bolts on this 1920s row home in Philadelphia. This is one of the most uncertain homes we've ever done any work on. It was deemed unsafe by the city of Philadelphia, which essentially means that structurally they're not sure it's safe for inhabitants to live in. We took over this project, and the first thing we do before we do the whole renovation, we have to clear this make-safe permit, and that involves working with a structural engineer, and he gives us whatever prescriptions he thinks are necessary. We then work with the city, they send an inspector out, and based on everyone's conversations, everyone's analysis, we're gonna need to install two star bolts on the facade of this to control some of that step cracking and some of that bulging. Most of that is due to water intrusion. It freeze thaw, it expands, it cracks the bricks. So we're gonna get these star bolts in so we can continue with demolition. We're gonna install them in such a way that they're adjustable so that when our mason's doing the pointing, we can, you know, pop them off temporarily and then put them back into place. But we wanted to make this video to show you how we install star bolts and some of the hardware, some of the equipment, some of the framing practices that we use. And Terry's here, he's loading up some of the material. Oh, Terry, what are you doing with those ridiculous glasses? Come on, we talked about this. I'm wearing a cowboy tuxedo and star glasses. We have a lot of work to do. This building is about to collapse. We're behind schedule, we're over budget. Can you stop doing annoying things, please? Count to 10. Think of the star as a washer, and what it's doing is keeping the front of the house, which is relatively freestanding. It's tied in with a couple bricks here and there into the party walls. But if you look up, the joists, the roof joists and the floor joists are almost always pocketed into the wall. So what we're doing is finding a mechanical way to connect the front wall into the joists, the floor joists or the roof joists running along. So we'll drill a hole through, thread the all thread, attach a star, and our joists almost always run parallel to the front wall. If there's cantilevers condition, there's other situations we can, other hardware we can do. The Simpson HUD 4 is a bracket that we're gonna use for a temporary star bolt. It lags into the joist. Say this wall was the joist. And then there is an adapter plate that goes in here. Allows for some deflection. But in this case, we're talking about traditional install. We're gonna drill through the floor joist, thread this all thread through, put blocking along so we tie in all the strength of the three joists that we drilled through. Put a steel plate on the back to spread weight, and you know, hopefully we'll get enough of them in the right place that we keep the front stabilized. Very difficult to correct the bulge once it happens without rebuilding the wall itself, but we can stop further movement. And yeah, they're really common in Philadelphia. Every time you drive around, I used to think for the longest time they were decorative, but they're actually structural and have a purpose. One thing to note, these don't come painted. We pre-paint them before we put them up. We'll silicone the back. We'll leave the top open, or the bottom open, so any water can drain through. This whole assembly costs about $50. We installed three of them in about 3 hours while accommodating and filming, so really not that difficult to do. Expect to pay about $500 per star bolt for a contractor to install them without any drywall work. So we're gonna work on placement first. We're gonna use the windows as reference points and then figure out which course of brick we need to go through. The inside ceiling has already been demoed, so we can see where the bottom and the top of the joists are. We can use the windows as references and figure out the height we need to drill through. We're gonna drill a hole from the outside with this rotary hammer. There's no power here, so we can't use our big gun. So we're gonna use our trusted Ryobi one, see if it's up to the task. We're gonna drill a pilot hole through. If we're a little low or a little high, if we hit a knot, then we can, you know, easily patch this quarter inch hole. So once we figure that out, then we will drill all the way through. We'll use a bigger one, expand the hole so it can fit the all thread through. And then we'll do our second one. Let's go. All right, so we've got 59 inches here. Half of that is 29 and a half. So that puts us right on this brick here. So right now we're gonna figure out, you know, that's roughly the center of the space that we're centered in between. And now we're gonna go find out how far this is to the bottom and the top of the joist so we know how high to drill through.
We're using the window as our point of reference for determining where the joist is on the exterior so that we know where to drill our pilot hole through.
So make sure you're not filming what I'm standing on right now because we didn't bring a little step ladder into the shot. But these joists are 7.5 inches thick and we're gonna say the bottom of our capping comes to right about here for this line. So 18 inches to the bottom of the joist plus 7.5 is, so we have between 18 and 25.5 that we need to land our serve bolt through. So we use the bottom of this edge as a reference on the inside. So we're gonna measure 18 inches, which puts us there, and 25.5 inches there. So theoretically, our joist is running between here and here. So we're gonna put our first star bolt right here. We'll check it out from the ground. Make sure it looks centered visually. I'm gonna go a little bit to the left and I wanna be drilling in the middle of a brick. So I'm gonna shoot one right in there. Let's see how we did. So we're right through there, right where these old radiator pipes are. Not terribly worried about them, they're coming out. Let's get it through with a bigger bit. Let's see if this little Ryobi's up to the task. We're gonna drill through the brick. We'll be able to feel it as it goes to the first and second chorus of brick. We're probably not gonna use this to drill through the wood. It's not what it was meant for. We know where the location is, so we can use a bigger spade bit or an auger to drill from the inside. And then we'll line everything up with our laser level. Through the first course of brick, which is usually a glazed brick or a fire coated or fire treated brick. Inside bricks are usually a little softer, so hoping this goes through a little bit better. So we are through now, and now we're getting to wood. It seems to be cutting, so I'm gonna send it. See how we did? You wanna try this one?
I kinda wanna yank this down.
Okay. Carefully. Con cuidado. Whatever can go wrong will go wrong. You got goggles? And this bit's probably sharper. Got your hearing protection in?
Yeah.
My man.
Man, these pipes.
Yeah, sir. Alright, what distance we got?
Just shy of 48 inches.
Toss him the tape. Most houses built around this time had really good craftsmen, really good framers, so we are assuming that this door frame is straight, the vestibule. 9 times out of 10 they are. So we are getting this mark at 48 inches and lining up with the center, which is 48 inches. Now we'll mark the bottom of the beams. So we will know where to drill through. We're gonna go through 3 stud bays per the engineer's requirements. And then once they're up, we'll install blocking. So now that we've found the line that they're going on, We're about 4.5 inches up.
Guess I'm taking a shower today. Not big enough.
All right, so the hole was a little bit small. We're gonna try to expand a little bit with the SDS plus bit. Terry, let me grab that drill. Oh, God damn it, Terry.
There you go, buddy.
Right on the radiator pipe, my over under.
All right, go. Push. Go.
One more to go, or?
Yeah, and I don't have a safe way of getting to it.
You don't have a safe way of getting to it?
Huh?
You don't have a safe way of getting to it?
No.
And we can hammer it in from the other side. Let's do the hole.
This is the center of the lintel, right here. And it's also same height as that one. And it's just like the brick that's bulging out the most.
So right now, these bricks are a little too loose for our likings. Ideally, we drill here and this brick. I think we're gonna have to drill here and we'll try to line it up with the lintels. We are about a full brick length in. So if we go through that one right there, really carefully and slowly, maybe we'll step it up in size. I think that should work.
Oh, you're perfect, Terry.
Rather than using just the big bit, Terry is gonna step up gradually from 1/4 inch all the way to up to 1/2 inch to see if we can gradually make the hole. The brick is super loose up there, so we wanna keep as much intact as possible.
Merci beaucoup. We want the washer to catch on as much wood as possible. And we drilled through the joist with this 1¼-inch paddle bit. So what we're gonna try to do is use a 3/4-inch paddle bit to create a smaller hole so that the washer that's holding the star bolt in has more wood that it's catching.
So we're installing blocking from this joist all the way to this joist. And the thought behind that is, if this joist were ever to flex, it's gonna pick up the strength of this joist, and you're gonna pick up the strength of this joist. So, you know, it turns the rigidity that you're getting from one perpendicular joist into 3. Actually, 4. All right, we're tightening these on. So normally before we set them permanently, we'll put a little bit of silicone behind there, and we'll make sure we pack the hole out. These are gonna be, you know, loosened temporarily as we deem appropriate when the brick is being pointed. So these are just for structural security during demolition. So I'm threading them on. We're also leaving these a little bit long so it gives us room to play with. Hey. Okay. I want to get one more star bolt in on this wall. This wall is a little bit precarious. There's no real good way to fasten it in just because the joists are cantilevered out and they run this way and the wall's running this way. So I'm going to get a temporary piece of wood screwed onto the floor joist through the subfloor. We're going to attach a piece of hardware to mount the star bolt through this brick wall and just temporarily catch it. It's not permanent, just for when we're doing demolition. All right, so this is just super temporary. I'm gonna screw this 2x10 down to the floor. We're gonna attach a Simpson HUD 50 bracket, drill a hole through the wall, and then we're gonna attach a star bolt temporarily. Just to give, you know, a little bit of rigidity, just so the wall doesn't wanna move and then we'll be able to know if it does. I've marked out where the joists are. This is super temporary. I'm only using these little screws until we get some bigger lag bolts. We'll do that right before the demo guys start. Get a star bolt in there. Our engineer is not worried about this wall. I just wanna make sure to have some belt and suspenders on, just, you know, to sleep better at night. Bracket, it's screwed onto this wood. We'll drill our all thread through the wall. We'll attach a star bolt over there. And once the demo is complete and we get some framing in, we'll put something permanent in place. All right, so with these brackets, you don't have to be perfectly straight. Again, this is temporary, so we're not gonna measure everything out. This is, you know, it's in. Again, we're gonna use lag bolts into the joists before we do any demo. This is just to hold everything in place. So I'm gonna go right through the brick. All right, we'll get there. All right, we're just tightening this up. These brackets are pretty cool. They factor if it's not done perfectly straight. You can see this crescent kind of moves in the shape and the contour. So we're just gonna tighten this up. Not too tight. And we should be in business. All right, again, totally temporary, but yeah, you know, we just wanted to extend this up, down a little bit, get a little star bolt action in here. Not doing anything other than making us sleep better at night. Star bolts are in. We're gonna get one more up top after we get some framing in the walls, but there's not been any movement on the wall, which is a great sign. It means there's no, you know, immediately quick settling. But that being said, we have scaffolding set up. We are getting ready to point. Once that's done, we're gonna finalize everything, seal the star bolts in, tighten them up to the proper tension, and hopefully they will never be touched again. So if you're still following along, we hope you enjoyed what you saw. It means you like building houses almost as much as we do. Be sure to subscribe and toss a couple comments or likes our way. It truly means a lot to us. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you on the next project.